Welcome to Snake Island. In the last episode, I spent the day relaxing on a quiet beach and was blessed by a heavy rain that provided me more than enough water. Then I received a visit from a huge, friendly green iguana that nearly kissed my camera. This episode begins with a pleasant morning after a well-rested night lying in my hammock under the trees of Tampico Beach.
Rain last night. This is my blanket. Oh, it feels so good to sleep in a hammock. I tell you, that was the best night of sleep I've had since I got here. A hammock is the best way to sleep out on the islands. Today is a new day. I have to admit, it's been very difficult these past 4 days. It's been exhausting on my body. And I still feel I need to recover. My feet are sore, my legs are sore. My legs are mostly sore from all the noceum bites. But also got a little bit of sunburn on my back. And so it looks like it's gonna be a very sunny day. There's a nice breeze, which was good for the night because it definitely kept the bugs away. But I think this is a good camping spot nonetheless, even if it's not breezy. So I'm gonna spend the day here. And it's going to be an arts and crafts day. I'm going to make things that are both useful and maybe things just for the fun of it. I'm going to try to start a fire. I'm going to try to catch fish because my body really needs some protein to heal. So it's early, the sun is just coming up. I have all day to try to accomplish these things and just relax. I have plenty of water for the day. So there's no need to get stressed out. Just take it easy.
Since I'm going to be spending the whole day here, I decided to try out the evapotranspiration technique to collect drinking water from the leaves of the portia tree. By the end of the day, there should be some water collected in the bottom of the bags. Hermit crabs are really common on this part of the island. There are two distinct groups of hermit crabs, those that live in the water and those that live on land. The land-dwelling hermit crabs still need to wet their gills at times in order to survive, but are often found quite a distance from the sea. This morning, I'm on a mission to collect some aloe vera leaves for washing and healing my sun-parched skin. There's a spot I know over here where aloe vera grows. Aloe vera is said to have originated in the dry landscapes of northern Africa. However, it is now found in warm climates worldwide.
This stuff is great for washing your hair. I'm gonna try washing my clothes with it too.
Three nice leaves. This little plumeria flower. Having free time in nature is a great opportunity to be creative. If you think about it, everything in our modern world was originally birthed from nature through the creative minds of men and women. Native tribespeople were masters at a creativity that remained harmonious with nature. While lying in my hammock, I thought of a creative way to make a fashion statement. I just need some plant material. The sound of a bird in the trees above provided the perfect background music for my task. A one-of-a-kind sea grapes had to protect me from the sun. The rash on my legs is looking less like noceum bug bites. It looks more like severe acne, but it still painfully burns. A measurable amount of water is already collecting in the evapotranspiration bags. The tide always seems to deliver to me useful gifts. This object is a rather primitive fishing buoy. It's time for my bath and skin repair treatment. The aloe vera works great on hair, but not so effective on clothing. The application of raw aloe vera really soothes and cools sunburnt skin. It really felt great to relax these past 2 days and allow my thoughts to be free to create. The possibilities are limited only by our minds. For me, one idea led to another, and I had so much fun seeing my ideas materialize. Now let's see if we can catch a fish on this. For For bait, I used a small piece of chitin I removed from the reef. Frustrating. I was unable to catch a fish, but I do have one tool that can get me some protein. This. Look closely here. There's all kinds of sea life. There's one in particular that can make a tasty little meal if you get enough of them. They're called chitons. These guys right here. Very camouflaged. Have this armor plating that protects their bodies. And it's really hard to get off. That's the underside. That's the part that's edible. Chitons and sea urchin. That's what I'm gonna eat. Smash it open. What you eat is this little yellow roe here. That's what's served in sushi restaurants. Don't taste bad at all. I could get used to this. Just kind of weird eating it while the animal's still moving. Chitons. A little more edible material on the chitin. I'm gonna rinse that out, remove the guts. Just eat the muscular foot, which is what it attaches, uses to attach to the rocks. It's very tough. But it makes a good fishing bait. It stays on the hook very well. I call this nature's fast food. There's plenty of those. I can eat those all day long. It's been 2 days here so far. It's a really nice place. I could stay longer. Really relaxing. It's been like a vacation. But I only had 3 liters of water for the day, and that's almost used up, which means I have to get more water. It doesn't look like it's gonna rain, so I have to go to the town to get more water. I can do that either tonight or tomorrow morning. So speaking of water, let's see how much my little experiment collected. Whoa! I have to say, I'm quite amazed. Look at that. These little baggies collected quite a bit of water in them. Oh, that's nice. Very nice. And the big one, practically have a goldfish swimming in there. Look at that.
And that took about most of the day, probably 6 hours, something like that. But it's good to know. It's good to know that you can have that as a backup in a very serious survival situation. If you have some plastic bags, you can put them on trees that have green leaves that are growing, and you can collect water from them. It's not a lot, but it definitely helps.
Now I'm collecting the evapotranspiration bags to see exactly how much water they produced from the portia tree. All right, see how much water we collected. Two baggies. Three baggies. Plus a big one. Probably about an ounce and a half. Not much. But it's water. As this day closes, I'm anxious for tomorrow to continue the expedition and explore more of the island. On the next Snake Island Survival Adventure. After a difficult night being bitten by mosquitoes and then a quick breakfast of raw chitons, followed by a morning swim, I make my way to Flamenco Beach to fill up my containers with water, then explore the western shore from Carlos Rosario to Melones Beach and revisit the place where I tasted the fruit of the world's most dangerous tree 2 years earlier.